In Sakai, there are two basic ways that information gets recorded in the gradebook. Grades can be sent automatically to the gradebook from several Sakai tools, such as tests and quizzes and assignments. For other graded work, you'll need to manually create an item and enter grades within the gradebook. In this video, we'll talk about some examples of items you might add directly to the gradebook, and then we'll look at how to create an item, as well as how to enter grades and provide feedback. So, what types of items might an instructor add directly to the Sakai gradebook? Well, some examples are homework collected in class, online forum discussion topics, and class attendance. In this example, we'll add a gradebook item to the gradebook so I can enter grades for a paper-based homework assignment I collected in class. From the course menu, click Gradebook, and then Add Gradebook Item. The Add Gradebook Item box appears. In the title field, we'll give this item a distinguishing name, such as Week 1 Homework, so students will know exactly what this item is. Then in the Point Value field, I'll type the maximum points for the homework item. Now we'll move on to the Due Date field. Providing a due date is optional, but recommended. It will display in the gradebook for both the instructor and for students, and can be a useful reminder if you ever need to reference when this gradebook item was due. To select a due date, click the field next to Due Date, and select the date from the calendar that appears. Alternatively, you can type the due date in the field. If you set up your gradebook with categories, click the drop-down menu next to Category and select a category. In this example, we'll select the homework category. By default, the box next to release this item to students is checked. This option allows your students to see this gradebook item in the gradebook once it's created. If it's not already selected, you'll usually also want to check Include this item in course grade calculations to ensure the item is used in calculating your student's final course grade. However, if this were a practice assignment, we'd recommend leaving this option unchecked. We'll click Create, and a message appears letting you know the item's been added to the gradebook. Ah yes, I can see it here under the homework category. That's the category I selected for it. Let's take a closer look at the cell containing the name of the assignment. The information in this cell allows us to verify the assignment's maximum points and its due date. Since this and the item's title are the only information appearing in the cell, I know that this item is released to students and is going to be calculated in the final grade. In other words, if you choose to not release the item to students, a crossed out I icon appears in the cell. And if the item is not being calculated in the final grade, a crossed out calculator icon appears. Okay, let's talk about how to enter grades. I've already graded the assignment I collected for my students, and I'm ready to enter their grades into this new gradebook item. In the first column, I'll locate the student, and then I'll move across the student's row and click the cell that intersects the gradebook item's column. An empty field appears in the cell. This student earned the maximum number of points for this assignment, so I'll enter 100 in the field. The student also made an interesting observation in one of her responses, and I'd like to write her a comment about that. So I'll click the drop-down arrow in the cell and select Add Edit Comment. A box appears allowing me to type my comment, and then I'll click Save Comment. A comment icon appears in the cell to let me know my comment's been saved. Let's take a look at what the student will see on her end. I'll click her name to open her grade summary, and then I'll click Student Review Mode. When this student reviews her grades, she'll see her grade, and my comment appears in the Comments column. Click Done to close the summary, and then click Continue to return to the gradebook. Here's a few tips to help you as you work with the gradebook. You can quickly move from one cell to the next one down in the gradebook by pressing Enter or the down arrow on your keyboard. Other navigation keys include the Tab key to move to the right, as well as the other directional arrow keys. If a student doesn't submit an assignment, always remember to enter a zero. Leaving a cell blank is the same as forgiving the assignment. In other words, a blank cell has no impact on the student's overall grade. To give several students a grade of zero for an assignment, locate the gradebook item's name in the top row of the spreadsheet. Click the drop-down arrow in the lower right corner of its cell and select Set Score for Empty Cells. The default score in the Grade Override field is 0. Clicking Done and then Continue applies that score to all students who have no grade for this item. Another feature available through the Gradebook Item's drop-down arrow is View Grade Statistics. This feature provides information on how the class performed on an assignment. As you're working with the gradebook, you may notice a padlock icon in some columns. This means that grades are being sent to this column from another tool in Sakai. In this case, you won't be able to enter the grades here. You'll do that in the originating tool. You can learn more about this in our videos on grading tests and quizzes, assignments, and forums in Sakai. Okay, I think you're ready to add and grade items in your gradebook. If you need assistance, please contact Sakai Help at durhamtech.edu.